Okay, so here's a quick rundown for the article I gave you guys, The Man in the Water by Roger Rosenblatt. On January 13th, 1982, Air Florida Flight 90 was taking off. It was super icy and cold outside. They didn't de-ice the plane long enough. The pilots decided to take off, and what happened was, as the plane was frozen, it couldn't get a lot of ground. So it hit the 14th Street Bridge in Washington, D.C. As it took off from the airport, it clipped a bridge, and the bridge had a freeway running over it. So as the plane hit the freeway, it took seven cars with it, went over the bridge, and crashed into the icy river. There were 74 passengers on the airplane and five crew. Only five people survived the accident from the airplane. Outside of that, there were another four people who were killed who were driving cars on the freeway. So for paragraph one, this is just setting up the situation, what happened. It's painting a picture of the contrast between the icy gray of the city and the blue and green of the airplane. That nothing is really particularly special about this airplane crash. It wasn't even, the life toll wasn't even as big as some of the other crashes that have happened. But there was something very special about it. And then we go to paragraph two, and that is that this accident was recorded on television, and we watched the rescue happen. People at home saw heroism from everyday individuals, and this is what makes the accident special. We go to paragraph three, and they start mentioning there are four big heroes of the event, three of which who survived. There were two pilots, Donald Usher and Eugene Windsor, who were just park police on their regular patrol. And they saw the accident, they flew the helicopter over, and they kept dropping the helicopter just about to the river so people could grab onto the skids and they lift them up and take them out. There's another guy, Lenny Skutnik, who was 28. He just worked at the Congressional Budget Office, just a regular, 9 to 5 job. He was walking home, saw what happened. He saw a woman swimming or trying to swim. He took his coat off, jumped in, and saved her. And when the news reporters asked him, why'd you even go into that icy water? He said, well, somebody had to. So he was super humble about it. In paragraph four, they talk about this fourth guy. They didn't know who he was. His name is Arlen D. Williams Jr. We know that now. But when this was written, they didn't know who he was. He saved two people. And what he did is, as the plane went down and it sank, the tail was sticking out of the water. So he was with five other people at the tail holding on. And every time a helicopter came by and dropped the lifeline, he made sure the people around him were safely attached first. And then he let them get saved by the helicopter. Finally, when the helicopter came back for him, the tail had gone underwater and he wound up drowning. Paragraph five, it kind of flashbacks a little bit. It talks about the man before the crash, like just totally regular guy. Maybe he was sleeping on the airplane, maybe he was just not paying attention to the stewardess talking about the seats. It was just a totally normal day, and then all of a sudden, the accident happens, and he just knows what he has to do. In paragraph six, the author mentions that the guy who's saving these people, this man in the water, he knows that he's going to die, but he decides to keep continuing to help other people. He could at any minute put the lifeline around his waist and be carried away to safety, but he keeps helping others before himself. Paragraph seven, the author compares the man in the water to nature. So nature doesn't care about who lives or dies. There's no bad or good. It's just pure neutrality. It's just force. In comparison, there's this guy who knows what's right and wrong, and he's gonna fight as long as he possibly can, and he's gonna save as many people as he can. Paragraph eight, it's, not every person would have reacted in the same way in that situation, but everybody has the capability to do what he did. Everybody has the potential to be a hero, right? And when the moment arrives of an accident or a catastrophe or something dire, we all have the ability to do it. It just depends on the choice we make in that moment. Paragraph nine, the man in the water, he's fighting against the power of nature, but he himself has the power of nature, right? Because he's a living being, so he's a piece of nature. The author here brings up a quote by Emerson. What he's saying is that he's fighting equally with nature. And though ultimately he dies, the important thing is that he does the right thing, and he's something we can all look up to. So that's just a quick rundown of what the article is about. Don't forget to do the worksheet. Let me know if you have any questions. Take care.